सुप्रभात बच्चों, गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीबॉडी। वी हैव एंटर्ड इनटू द न्यू सेशन ऑफ द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द ईयर। सो वील प्रे लॉर्ड गणेश टू ब्लेस अस फॉर द बेटरमेंट ऑफ आवर लाइफ एंड टू इम्प्रूव आवर स्टडी। सो लेट अस फर्स्ट प्रे लॉर्ड गणेश। ओम गणेशाय नमः। सभी का स्वास्थ्य अच्छा रहे और सभी लोग आराम से पाठ पढ़ें और अपना भविष्य उज्जवल करें। ओम गणेशाय नमः। सो टुडे वील स्टडी अबाउट द डिफरेंट नंबर्स। इन दिस सेशन we'll start from the beginning that what is the natural number, prakriti se jo prakriti se humko mila hai for counting the numbers. So let us start about the natural number. So natural number is denoted as capital N. All the counting numbers starting from 1, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 to infinity, are called your natural number. Because we are counting any things from 1, not from 0. So, 1 is the starting of the natural numbers. Next, we will come to the whole number. And this whole number is denoted as capital W, capital letter W. So, what is the definition of whole number? All the counting numbers starting from 1 and 0 are called whole number. So, it is denoted as W. So, you see here W equal to, this is your curly bracket start and curly bracket end. So, everywhere you have to write the curly bracket. So, whole number is W equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 to infinitives. Next, we will discuss about integers. So, it is represented as I or Z. In some book, it is the mathematician have taken it I, or in some book, it is taken as Z. So, integers, the definition of integers is all the counting numbers with their negatives included with zero are called integers. So, we are coming from natural number, then whole number, then now integers. So, integers is represented as Z. So, Z you start like this, zero, center say start with zero. Then if you go to right hand side, you will get the positives, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to infinity. But from 0, if you go to the negative sides, you will get the negative of that number, negative of a number, that is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, like this manner. So always you start from 0, then it will go to infinity, here it will go minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, like this manner. So these are the integers. Now, the fourth one is rational number. Rational number is your chapter, that is the rational number. So, rational number is represented as small r. So, a number which can be expressed in the form of p by q. Which can be expressed in the form of p by q. Where p, q are integers and q not equal to 0. Q, this is very very important. This is very important point. Q not equal to 0. If q equal to 0, then it is not a rational number. Because you will get the exercises by using this formula. So it is represented as R. R is equal to P by Q, where P and Q are integers, whatever the integers here, and Q not equal to 0. So, this is about your rational number and the chapter is rational numbers. And next is your the role of 0. You say that 0 has no meaning or new value, but it has a value in different places. In different places, zero has very big value. Just like your suppose 10, when you are writing 10, so zero has a very great value. Similarly, 100. But in the cases of right like this 2.0, so in this case it has no value. But 2.05, again it has a value. So in different places, zero has a value. So we should know about the role of zero. So the role of zero, that is zero is called the identity for addition of rational number. Suppose you are taking 5 plus 0. So what will you get? 5. The same number you are getting when you are adding any number with 0, then you are getting that number only. So 0 is called the identity for addition of rational number, but additive identity for addition. So 0, the other name of 0 is additive identity for addition. Next is, we know about the role of 1. The role of 1 is called the multiplicative identity for rational number. Suppose here A by B into 1. So again you are getting the same number A by B. But you are taking the second example, suppose 5 into 1. So you are getting 5 only. Or if you are getting n into 1, then you are getting n. So 1 is called the multiplicative identity for rational number. When you are multiplying by 1, then you are getting the same number. Same rational number you are getting here. A by B into 1 is A by B. There is no changes in that. Similarly, suppose next is negative of a number. Suppose plus 5. Then what is the negative of this number? Negative of 5 is minus 5. Okay? So negative of a number, that is of 5, is minus 5. Similarly, suppose minus a by b is the additive inverse of a by b. Negative of a number is also known as additive inverse. Similarly, suppose 2 by 3, and if you add minus 2 by 3 to this number, then plus minus is cancelled out, so you are getting 0. So the additive inverse of 2 by 3 is minus 2 by 3, or the additive inverse of minus 2 by 3 is 2 by 3. Suppose there is a question, find the additive inverse of 2 by 7. So you see here, if you put one negative sign, then it is the additive inverse of 2 by 7. So additive inverse of 2 by 7 is minus 2 by 7. Okay? Additive inverse of 2 by 7 is minus 2 by 7, because 2 by 7 plus minus 2 by 7 is equal to, cancel out, you are getting 0. So that is the additive inverse. Suppose another example, minus 3 by minus 5. Suppose you want to find out the additive inverse of this number. So you be careful when you are writing here minus, then both the minus is cancelled out. So this may be written as 3 by 5. Therefore, additive inverse of minus 3 by minus 5 is minus 3 by 5. Because if you take minus 3 by 5, then you will get 0. So this is called the negative buffer number and the additive inverse of that number. Next is your reciprocal. Reciprocal, the other name of reciprocal is multiplicative inverse. See here the difference. It is multiplicative inverse. Here it is additive inverse. So because here additive means, you know that in mathematics there is different operations. That is your addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Just like in medical science, there is the operations. The doctor remove out the different diseases or your organs, unnecessary organs, by operations. Means that is subtraction. First you will cut, then it will be removed out. Similarly, in mathematics also, there are different operations. That is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Okay, because suppose a man is suffering from any diseases, if he or she has a tumor, so that tumor should be removed by operation. Similarly, in mathematical science also, you are doing the different mathematical operation. So you will know about reciprocal, that is the multiplicative inverse. Suppose there is a number 2 by 3. If you multiply this number by 3 by 2, then you see here numerator and denominator same number should be cancelled out. Similarly, 2 cancel out, then you will get 1. So if you multiply a number with its reciprocal or multiplicative inverse, then the result will be 1. Similarly, suppose there is a question 2 by 9, then multiplicative inverse of 2 by 9 is minus 2 by 9. But some children write that multiple inverse of 2 by 9. Here we will know about multiplicative inverse. Suppose there is a question that find the multiplicative inverse of 2 by 9. So you have to write here multiplicative inverse of 2 by 9 is 9 by 2. So how you can check? You see here 2 by 9 into its multiplicative inverse, that is 9 by 2. Then 9 cancel out, 2 cancel out, then you will get the result 1. So this is the final thing. Means if you multiply the number with its multiplicative inverse, then you will get 1. So these are about your rational numbers, that is the negative of a number, reciprocal of a number, and that reciprocal of a number is called multiplicative inverse. Now we'll discuss about the representation of rational number on the number line. Okay, so this is, you know, what is this? This is a ruler, scale. So first you take a ruler and draw a line. Okay, after drawing, here this I have taken inch side. So in every inch you mark a point. Okay, so just I have discussed about the integers. You take here 0, so this is 0. So if you take this side, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then if you are taking this side, then this side will be negative side. And this side is positive side. So here I have taken the positive side, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here you take minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, like this one. Suppose you want to represent 3 on the normal line. So automatically you write here A. So A represents 3. This is easy job. Suppose it represent minus 5. So B represents minus 5. These are easy job. But if the question is there, it represents 3 by 7. Represent 3 by 7. Or 4 by 7. Suppose you want to represent 3 by 7, 4 by 7, minus 6 by 7. Like this manner. So what you have to do here? You divide every number by 7. Because you see here 7. So 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7. You see here 7 by 7, that is now it is 1. Similarly here you take by 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7. Okay, so you want to represent 3 by 7. You see here A represents 3 by 7. Similarly, suppose B will be what? Minus 5 by 7. Minus 5 by 7. Suppose you want to, there is a question, you have to represent 4 by 7. Suppose you take here C. The C represents 4 by 7. Next question is minus 6 by 7. You see here, minus 6 by 7. Suppose I am writing here D. So D represents minus 6 by 7. So these are about your representation of rational numbers on the normal line, because this is the normal line. So you have to represent the numbers. Next is the rational number between two numbers. Suppose a number diya hai 1 by 2, dusra number diya hai 3 by 5. So you want to find out 2 or 3 or 10, any required to, according to the question, any numbers of rational numbers between these two numbers. So there is the question. Suppose you want to take this as R and this as S. So rational number between, this is the formula, rational number between 1 by 2, that is your R, and 3 by 5 is equal to half of R plus S. This is the formula. Half R plus S means your half is the formula. R half 1 by 2 plus S is 3 by 5. S is 3 by 5. So you have to take the LCM of 2 and 5. So the LCM of 2 and 5 is 10. So you write here 10. This is very important. So you see here, this is 2, this is 10. Means it is how many times? 5 times. So you have to write the 5 times of this numerator. The 1 into 5 is 5 plus. Then 5 here 10 means 2 times. This is 2 times of this number. So you take the 2 times of the numerator, that is 3 to the 6. Okay, so this is equal to half. 5 plus 6 11, 11 by 10. So now you multiply numerator with numerator. and denominator is denominator. So 1 into 11 is 11, 2 into 10 is 20. So 11 by 20. Suppose this is the number line. This is the number line. Here 1 by 2, here 3 by 5. So the rational number between these two is, that is 11 by 20. So this is one method. There is another method also. Similarly, suppose you want to find out the rational number between these two, then half of 1 by 2 and 11 by 20. Similarly, you want to find out the rational number between the two, then same formula, half R plus S. So if you practice more and more problems, then you can solve these problems. So these are about your rational numbers. You practice, then you will get good marks in your examination. Thank you.